So the ANR process or procedure, if you will, we begin with understanding the patient as a whole, as far as his medical conditions. We examine everything that the patient, whether it's high blood pressure, obesity, heart disease, we do the assessment. We do that. That's very thorough. And then we also want a history on what he's been using, okay, what types of opioids that this individual is on. And the we take it from there and we say, okay, you're at the point where you're either, as Dr. Weissman describes, you're either in chaos, okay, or you're actually in dependency and you're just using enough to keep you stable, to keep you where you are at. So all that goes into our medical evaluation. Once our medical evaluation has done and we have an that's our intake process, we've talked to them, then these individuals, our patients, will come and we'll admit them. And the good thing about this is that we continue to practice sound medicine by admitting them and understanding that we're taking a patient into a situation where we want to control the whole thing. And that requires ICU management. Okay, that requires hospitalization. So the team consists of people who have great experience in anesthesia and critical care management, as well as critical care nurses. And we employ all those aspects of medicine to make sure that our patient is safe. Safety is an important issue. Okay, we cannot not second guess anything regarding the patient's safety. And of course, once the patient is admitted, we proceed by doing some evaluation as to make sure that he comes in a very calm state the day of his procedure.